Hello and welcome to yet another module in physical education. And we are discussing about the modern trends in physical education, especially after independence. After independence in 1947, the government of India have taken various measures for development of physical education. Various organizations were set up and steps were taken to improve the condition of physical education. In 1948, National Cadet Corps and Auxiliary Cadet Corps at school and college levels were introduced. The Central Advisory Board of Physical Education and Recreation was constituted. This committee was set up in 1950 by Government of India. The board advised the government on various issues for the development of physical education in India. Various recommendations made by the board: development, training of leaders in physical education, institution of scholarship for research in physical education, conduct of national physical efficiency drive, conducting seminar on physical education, providing financial assistance to the colleges of physical education, providing directions to the state government for effecting the organization of physical education in their respective states. Rajkumari Coaching Scheme. This scheme was introduced by Government of India in 1953 with the aim of training good athletes and sportsmen. The scheme received wide popularity since famous players like Major Dhyan Chand, Dr. Ram Singh were working under this scheme. All India Council of Sports, Union Ministry of Education formed AICS in 1953 with the purpose of establishing a link between central government and various sports associations and federations. This council facilitates financial assistance to these federations and check proper utilization of funds. It worked on many programs to raise the standards of sports. National Discipline Scheme. This scheme was introduced in 1954 by the Ministry of Rehabilitation under the guidance of General J.K. Mosley with the aim of building strong youth of the nation. The scheme inculcated discipline and imparted training in Marstville among the younger generation in the refugee camps and colonies. In 1958, this scheme was transferred to the Ministry of Education and was enlarged to cover a number of high schools. In 1956, a national syllabus of physical activities was formed. In 1957, Lakshmibai College of Physical Education, Gwalior was set up by the Government of India. The college started a 3-year degree course in physical education. In 1973, the institute was given the status of national importance. Therefore, it was renamed as Lakshmibai National College of Physical Education. Ad hoc Inquiry Committee. In 1958, Ad hoc Inquiry Committee was set up to make an inquiry about India's poor performance and downward slides in Olympic Games. It suggested many ways to improve the standards of Indian competition in all games and sports, such as appropriate training and a special diet for the players. National Physical Efficiency Drive. It was launched by Ministry of Education in 1959-60 with the sole aim of motivating citizens to raise interest in physical fitness. The plan consisted of certain items of physical efficiency tests which prescribed standards for achievement. Kothari Commission. This committee was constituted in 1964. As per this commission, physical education not only aims at physical fitness but also has educational values. It contributes to physical efficiency, mental alertness and development of certain qualities like perseverance, team spirit, leadership and obedience to rules. At the pre-primary and early primary stages, the syllabus should aim at developing among children the mastery over basic skills such as walking properly, running, throwing, etc. At the secondary stage, the syllabus may contain sports, games and athletics in their standard form. After the primary stage, the syllabus should be planned separately for boys and girls. Rhythmic activities will have an appeal for girls, less strenuous games such as badminton, throw balls, etc. In 1965, Committee on Physical Education under the chairmanship of C.D. Deshmukh, set up by University Grants Commission for removing inadequacies in and raising the standards of physical education. The committee examined the present facilities for the same in Indian universities and colleges. The committee suggested that the universities and colleges must be provided better infrastructural facilities and coaching programs. Sports Authority of India, SAI. Asian Games were held successfully in New Delhi in 1982. After this, Department of Sports, Government of India formed Sports Authority of India on 25th January 1984. This organization was formed to increase and raise the standards of sports in India. The SAI undertook the responsibility to maintain and utilize grounds which were constructed, renovated for the 9th Asian Games held in 1982. It also implemented programs for achieving excellence in sports in different disciplines at international level. It also produces and manages sports coaches, educators and teachers, and look out other issues such as promotion and management of sports. National Policy of Education in 1986 emphasized the importance of physical education in following ways. Sports and physical education are an integral part of the learning process and will be included in the evaluation of performance. In nationwide infrastructure for physical education, sports and games will be built into the educational edifice. The infrastructure will consist of play fields, equipments, coaches and teachers of physical education as part of the school improvement program. Available open spaces in urban areas will be reserved for playgrounds. Efforts will be made to established sports institutions and hostels where specialized attention will be given to sports activity and sports related studies along with normal education. Appropriate encouragement will be given to those talented in games and sports. Efforts will be made to introduce yoga in all schools and also in teacher training courses. It is also recommended for a minimum of 10 periods per week for physical education activity in low primary and upper primary stages and 7 periods per week at the second stage. National Council of Educational Research and Training, that is NCERT, developed the national curriculum for elementary and secondary school in 1988. The health and physical education and sports included in the core curriculum. NCERT formed a revised curriculum for school education and in 1992, its revised edition in November 2000. Under the title National Curriculum Framework for School Education. In this curriculum, health and physical education as one of the core subjects in all levels of school educations is included. Ministry of Youth Affairs and Sports. An independent ministry was made on 27 May 2000. It has two separate departments named Department of Youth Affairs and Department of Sports. The role of Department of Sports is to create the infrastructure and promote capacity building for broad basing sports as well as for achieving excellence in various competitive events at the national and international levels. The Ministry of Youth Affairs and Sports has constituted All India Council of Sports, headed by Professor V.K. Malhotra, being its president in the rank of Ministry of State. All India Council of Sports has, among others, Shri Sachin Tendulkar, MP, Rajya Sabha, Shrimati P.T. Usha, Athletics, Shri Limba Ram for Archery, Ms. N. Kunjirani Devi for Weightlifting, Shri I.M. Vijayan for Football, Shri P. Gopichand for Badminton, Shri Baching Bhutia for Football. Shri Uday Shankar, CEO, Star India, Shri Vishwanathan Anand, Chess, Shri Sandeep Pradhan, Director General, Sports Authority of Gujarat, Secretary, Sports, Government of Madhya Pradesh, Secretary, Sports, Government of Assam, President, Secretary General, Indian Olympic Association, Secretary, Department of Sports, Government of India, Director General, Sports Authority of India, Director General, National Anti-Doping Agency, Vice Chancellor, Lakshmibai National Institute of Physical Education, Joint Secretary, Department of Sports, Government of India, as members. Secretary, Sports Authority of India is Member Secretary of the Council. Other members of the Council will be nominated in due course. The Council will be an advisory body for the Ministry of Youth Affairs and Sports and will advise the Ministry on matters relating to the promotion and development of sports and games in the country, including popularizing sports among youth as a way of life. Increasing outreach of sports to the rural and tribal areas, areas affected by left-wing extremism, Northeast and Jammu and Kashmir. Implementation of policies for promotion of sports and games in the country. Matters relating to promotion of inclusiveness in sports with special focus on women, differently abled tribals, etc. Preventing drug abuse in sports, fraud of age and sexual harassment of women in sport. Bringing professionalism, transparency and good governance in functioning of national sports federations. Ways and means to raise resources for the promotion of sports and games in the country, promotion of sports sciences and sports medicine. Augmenting sports infrastructure and ensuring its proper utilization, matters relating to participation and performance of sportsperson and teams in international sporting events, issues arising out of match fixing and other malpractices in competitive sports, ways and means to promote indigenous games in the country, early identification of sports talent and nurturing of the identified talent, integration of sports in educational curriculums in schools, colleges and universities, welfare measures for sportsperson. The Council may organize national, international conferences, seminars, symposia, etc. for promotion of sports and games in the country. The council will meet from time to time, at least once in a quarter, and deliberate on matters relating to the promotion and development of sports and games in the country. NAPESS is an authentic professional body in the field of physical education, duly accredited by the International Council of Health, Physical Education, Recreation and Sports. This professional body, with a tradition of more than 3 decades, strives to serve the cause of physical education by a vision to develop quality professional growth. The Central Advisory Board of Physical Education and Recreation was founded in 1950. Now it is known as National Association of Physical Education and Sports Sciences. NAPESS is a registered body and functions as per constitutions and bylaws of the association. This national body is activated by the enthusiasm and response by the large number of physical education personnel working in universities, colleges and schools, other institutions and establishments. The president and the secretary general is constantly in touch with the members and other agencies and get feedback about the steps to be taken to promote the growth of physical education. The executive committee meets twice or more number of times in a year to review the progress and problems faced by the profession. Physical education school curriculum policies. There is a general and popular saying that health is wealth. The following brief description of how physical education has been reflected in various policy and curricular documents may contribute to a better understanding of status of physical education in our school curriculum. Report of Secondary Education Commission 1952-53. The commission that was appointed to survey the problems of secondary state of school education as a whole made the following points with regard to health and physical education. Health education. Physical fitness and health education assume an importance that no state can afford to neglect. The emphasis so far has been on the academic type of education without proper consideration being given to the physical welfare and maintenance of proper standards for the pupils. Students should not only appreciate the value of health education but also learn the ways in which they can effectively maintain and improve their health. All students should be subjected to thorough medical examination and activities for promoting and safeguarding health, and should find a place throughout the school program. School health service should be extended to the community, as the health of the school children is determined not only during the hours spent at schools but also and more so the time spent at homes and in their neighborhood. Very little is being done in educational institutions in respect of the malnutrition of children. Physical education. Various activities should be planned to develop physical and mental health of students, cultivate recreational interest and skills, and promote the spirit of teamwork, sportsmanship and respect for others. Physical education is much more than drill or a series of regulated exercises. It includes all forms of physical activities and games which promote the development of body and mind. The school should go to the community and seek its assistance in the furtherance of the program of physical education. Unless all teachers of the school do not participate in activities along with a physical instructor, physical education will not be a success. Physical education not only aims at physical fitness but also has educational values. It contributes to physical efficiency, mental alertness, and development of certain qualities like perseverance, team spirit, leadership, and obedience to rules. It should include development exercises, rhythmic activities, sports and games, outing activities and group handling activities. At the pre-primary and early primary stages, the syllabus should aim at developing among children the mastery over basic skills such as walking properly, running, throwing, etc. Efforts will be made to establish sports institutions and hostels where specialized attention will be given to sports activity and sports related studies along with normal education. Appropriate encouragement will be given to those talented in sports and games. Due stress will be laid on indigenous traditional games. As a system which promotes an integrated development of body and mind, yoga will receive special attention. While re-emphasizing the above points, the program of action, that is POA, has mentioned that action in the following areas will be necessary to implement the policy objectives of NPE 1986. In deciding the curriculum load, the need to allocate sufficient time to sports and physical education, which the NPE 1986 holds an integral part of the learning process, should be kept in mind. Physical education and yoga should be introduced for at least 45 minutes per day, preferably just after assembly. Approved games should be included in the school timetable for at least 2 periods in a week. Special incentives need to be given to students who perform well in sports and game. Special incentives may be considered for subject teachers who perform extra duty in conducting classes in physical education like yoga, sports and games. The basic equipment such as football and volleyball may be provided to each school. Similarly, some amount of contingency may be provided to each school. A scheme for creation and improvement of playgrounds should be taken up on a phased basis under Jawahar Rozgar Yojana and Nehru Yuvak Kendras. An intensive and extensive program of teachers training to equip all subject teachers with necessary skills to impart training in physical education, games and yoga will be necessary. The present program to train and recruit physical education teachers for high schools should be expanded. New schools may be established, recognized only if playgrounds are available. A comprehensive system of inter-school tournaments and championships in select disciplines should be introduced over a period of time. This system should culminate in a national school championship. Special cash awards to winning schools and a special system of incentive for successful athletes also need to be introduced. I hope this information was of some use to all of you. Thank you so much for watching.